Okay, so we have our VLIW backward compatibility quiz. Let's work on a solution. We had a simple VLIW that had 64-bit instructions, and we were doing one of those at a time, and each of those were equivalent to two normal operations. Now we want to have a VLIW processor with four operations per cycle, and the way we want to do that while maintaining backward compatibility with the original version is to fetch, decode, and execute two of those 64-bit instructions per cycle. The question is this new processor a VLIW processor? The correct answer here is no, not really. Here's why. In a real VLIW processor, the compiler tells us which operations can be done in parallel by putting them in the same instruction, and then we try to do only one of those instructions per cycle. Thus, every cycle we are guaranteed that we are doing independent operations. When we run programs compiled for this processor, the compiler only guarantees that the two operations in the same instruction are in parallel. In fact, if we have something like this, where we have a data dependence, the compiler will put these operations into two separate VLIW instructions and put no ops for the second operation to ensure that we first do this and then we do this. If this processor now is trying to fetch, decode, and execute two such 64-bit instructions per cycle, it might easily fetch these two and try to do them in the same cycle, thus violating this dependence. So this type of processor is not a true VLIW processor because it would have to check for dependencies, which makes it similar to a normal superscalar processor.